And the long ball threat, Kyle Schwarber.
Kyle Schwarber.
And a pitch. And that's outside. And this one is off and running. Next offering in there for a strike. And that is strike one.
One.
Left-hand batter waits. And that is cut on and missed. And it's one and two.
He's a bad ball hitter, so even if you get him to chase pitches outside the zone, he still might beat you. Not an easy out by any means.
Just off the inside edge.
Really good take, especially two strikes.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Trey Turner now. That one finds the zone. That's strike one. At the belt and fires. Got the back going too soon. It's strike two.
Okay.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And there's one away. Here's Bryce Harper. In there, and it's 0-1.
0-1.
The pitch. That misses the zone. And now it's even 1-1. And there's a ball. Schwarber, the base runner at first with one out. Next offering is down low.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Ortiz makes the grab, and there are two down. Nick Castellanos at the plate now.
You have to be careful throwing and breaking pitches, even in an 0-0 count. He loves going after the off-speed stuff, and he's really good at hitting it.
And that's downstairs and outside. That one finds the zone, and that's strike one. Two outs. And a swing and a miss.
1-2.
Next pitch is outside.
2-2.
That one missed.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
On the ground, Adames. In plenty of time to first, and that is that. Back here in Milwaukee. Up now for Milwaukee, Bryce Turan. And here it comes. Popped up. And a foul ball. And there's a foul ball. Here's the 0-2. And this is inside. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. That one's back there. And caught on the warning track.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
Jackson Chourio stands in now and watches strike one. One out, base is empty. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And now it's William Contreras. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Ground ball, left side. Fires over to first. And that's the third out. All set for the start of the inning. And stepping in is the speedy Bryson Stott. And the right hander back to work. Fought off foul. Stott goes 6 feet 3 inches, hitting fifth in today's lineup. A former first round pick back in 2019. And he handles it himself for the out. JT Realmuto steps in.
Realmuto made his debut with the Florida Marlins all the way back in 2014. Had a pair of singles and 3 RBIs in the game.
Ball, that's down.
And that one missing low. Next pitch in for a strike, and it's 1-1. One down, base is empty. Fouls it off, still 1-2. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Sends it to first. 2 up, 2 down in the top of the second. 2 outs, base is empty. Brandon Marsh steps to the plate.
Brandon Marsh.
That's in there. Strike one.
0-1.
Swings through that one.
No ball, 2 strikes.
Way
one ball,
inside.
2 strikes.
Wouldn't
ball,
chase
outside.
That time. Stays alive. Second inning here, no score. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Now this is in the air down the line. Chorio squeezes it, and that back here at American Family Field, bottom of the second. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Willie Adames. Suarez back to work. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. Solo runner aboard to start the inning.
Everything came together for him. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. And even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
And Gary Sanchez at the plate. This to third, and that one finds its way through. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Just found a way to slot that ball down the third baseline. That's really excellent bat control, and it kind of goes back to all those drills you see hitters do off the tee where it's placed in different spots. That was just nice.
And now Garrett Mitchell. Next offering is in for a strike. Just missed.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. 2-ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute, finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
2-2 down. Ducks and misses. It's a strikeout. And the batter down is Reese Hoskins. Chip swing, now a look down to first. No, he held up. Adames over at second. Sanchez at first, one gone. Back to the mound, it hit him. And they get the out after the ricochet. Sal Freeland up now for the Brewers.
It's early, but these at-bats can impact the game just as much as they do later. Here's a chance to set the tone early for your team.
And he takes one right on the black.
Man, that pitch was dotted. So much talent on display when this guy's out there on the hill.
And it skips in the dirt. And that's downed away.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Two on, two outs. And downstairs.
That's a really good take.
Got him! Huge strikeout there. New inning getting started. And digging in for Philadelphia, Cody Clemens.
Cody Clemens.
Savali back to work. Just off the outside edge. Ball one. Right through there for a strike. To third. And that one handled. One up, one down. So up next, Johan Rojas. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond. And this guy is at the top of the list. Fastball for a strike. 1-1. And you played behind guys, and they love having your speed out there defensively. Ball. One of the things that we talk about is how much pitchers enjoy having those elite defenders behind them. Ground ball up the middle. Adames. The throw to first. And that quickly, two away. So the Philly batting order turns over. Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. He reached out a walk his first time. Outside corner, there's a strike.
Logan, the one thing about that is speed never goes in a slump, and defense shouldn't either. Hitting wise, you can struggle, you can lose your mechanics, but the thing that you can do consistently,
a swing and a miss, that retires the side. And we're back as we go to the last of the third. Here's the rookie third baseman, Joseph Ortiz. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
He was all over that one. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
This is Bryce Terang. That's ball for a strike. And a pitch. Drilled to right, way back there, and that is gone. He powers that one out of here, and they lead it. It's 2-0. Now the number two hitter, Jackson Chourio. Right through there for a strike.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning. Bats coming up and a home run already surrendered. He's really going to have to execute against next couple of batters.
Nobody on, nobody out. A pair of runs across in the inning here in the last half of the third. Missed with a changeup. And that's ball two. Good eye right there.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
And down on strikes. And that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer. Now here is William Contreras. Grounded out his first time. He swings and fouls one off. All right, Chris, when you talk about great logos, the Milwaukee Brewers, the M and the B that form a glove, not everyone even realizes that it's an M and a B with that glove. They started using it in 1978 and have been using it a lot more recently. It's a great logo, Chris.
Yeah, Boog, I remember as a kid, my brother had that ball cap, and I would just kind of borrow it. Some would say steal it, but it was just such a cool-looking logo. I had no idea until years later that that's what was hidden on the inside of it, that M and that B, but very, very cool.
Swings and misses, struck him out. Two outs, base is empty. Willie Adames stands in. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. Misses just off the outside edge. I think that was a strike. If you're playing right now, tweet out, I was this many days old when I found out the Brewers glove logo is an M and a B. Well, gonna pause on that thought, as that'll do it for the inning. Onto the fourth, here's Trey Turner.
When he steps into the batter's box, the comfort level looks so high. It doesn't matter what kind of delivery that pitcher has, what kind of velocity, what kind of secondary stuff. He is so settled in there, he owns the home plate area.
Throws to first, and they get Turner for the out.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Harper in the box with one away as he takes ball one. Lined into left center, base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
Harper stands at first with one out. And now 2-0.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, you're going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
And the right-hander deals. 3-1. And another ball. Tapped softly on the ground, Ortiz. And Castellanos is out.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out in front, rolled over on it. Exactly what he was supposed to do.
This is Bryson Stott. Grounded out his first time up. That's in there. It's 0-1. Ripped to third, but handled, and that'll end the inning. And welcome back to the ballpark. Here's Gary Sanchez now. And he deals. In today's game, you look at exit velocity as a measure of process, and if guys are hitting the ball hard, eventually the results usually follow. Gary Sanchez, he is a guy that hits the ball hard. Got him swinging. Next for the Brewers, Garrett Mitchell. Struck out swinging his first time. Going
0-1.
And ball one. And that one's a little bit low. 2-1. Good eye in that spot.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
Right through there for a strike. And that's ball four.
Oh, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at bats?
Ooh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Bound back our way, and that's out of play.
If it were an average catcher behind the plate, I'd say take second base, but this isn't a catcher you want to run on. His quick release is unreal.
Swing and a miss, and it's nothing in two.
0-2.
Step off throw to first, and he just got his hand in there. The pitch. That's foul off to the right side, keeps the AB going.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
Man at first, one away. Kicks and deals. Got him looking. Picks up strikeout number 7. Next for Milwaukee, Sal Freeland. His first at bat was a strikeout. Runner on the goal. Pitch in for a strike. Real Mutual throws that in time. It's a stolen base.
High leg kick hangs in the air, but he read it nicely. And now in scoring position to add on to this lead.
That one lifted to left. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Back here in Milwaukee, we go to the top of the 5th, and up to the plate is JT Realmuto. The pitch. Bounce to the left side. Adames, the throw to first. One away here in the 5th. Brandon March stands in for the Phillies.
The left fielder, Brandon March.
That's in for a strike.
He's controlling things out there on the mound, not messing around at all. He's been in attack mode since the very start.
And a foul ball. Foul ball. It stays nothing and 2. One down, base is empty. Good job to fight that one off.
No, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Way inside, gets out of the way. And a swing and a miss. And there's 2 down. So digging in now for Philadelphia, Cody Clemens. He's 0 for 1. Wouldn't chase that time. Clemens goes 6'1", 200 pounds, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Brings it in, and that is that. Back here at American Family Field, bottom of the inning. Here's the third baseman, Joseph Ortiz. Hawaii to kick the pitch. And it's fouled away. And the 0-1. Swing and a foul straight back. The line to the pitch. And they'll do it again. Foul ball still 0-2. And that one hammered. Back there. And that is gone. He made him pay for that one, and they tack on to their lead. It's 3-0. Bryce Terang up now for the Brewers. That one catches the zone. Strike 1.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Next offering upstairs.
1-1.
Bounced out to short, and that squirts through.
Just a simple ground ball the other way. They've got eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Chorio in the box again, takes a strike.
This is a great dynamic right here. Speedy runner at first, thinking about taking second. Catcher with the pop time that leaves jaws on the floor. This might get interesting, Boo.
And that one pulled foul.
This is one of those situations the infielders have to pre-plan and understand that the ball's got to be hit extremely hard right at them if they're going to have a chance to go for a double play.
And that one a little below the knees. And the count 1-2. On the ground to third.
boots it.
And no shot to get him at first. There's two aboard. New arm out of the bullpen, Max Lazar.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Stepping in, William Contreras. Ball one there. Fastball.
1-1.
And that's in the dirt. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2.
When those hitters count, sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
Down and full.
A base hitter to right. Terrain around third. Safe.
Well, they're called out of advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
0-2.
Hit, connect on the curveball, struck him out.
The bat.
Gary Sanchez now, 1-2. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. And the 1-0. Big swing and a miss.
When you got a catcher like this guy with a big arm like that behind the plate, it really shuts down the running game.
And it stays fair. Churio around third. The throw in. Not in time. He's safe. A run comes in on the play.
Comes through with the RBI. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
And here is Garrett Mitchell.
Well, I'll say this as a former position player and base stealer. When you come into a game and you've got a guy like this behind the dish with a big arm, you really have to change your approach. Can't try to steal because you'll get thrown out. Maybe get a little bigger lead, be aggressive on the secondary. But this type of guy shuts the running game down.
Two on, one out. On the ground, a short could be two. To second, there's one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice. And it's Reese Hoskins up to the dish.
The hitter knows that if he can beat out the back end of this double play, that runner from third is going to score. That's an RBI. You help your team, and you keep the line moving. Really good job right there.
Top of the zone, and it's called a strike.
0-1. If he's going to steal second, you want him to go early in the count. That way,
runner on the move, pitch in for a strike. Real Muto grows, not in time. It's a stolen base. Two outs and one in scoring position.
This guy's seen two changeups in a row. Could be a little vulnerable for a fastball right here.
And there's a ball. Shot to third. Over to first. That'll end the inning after a lot of score. And we're back. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder, Johan Rojas. Savali back to work. Swing and a miss. As he was out front that time.
Well, these Phillies just aren't putting great swings on the baseball in this one. They've got to be frustrated with how many balls they're hitting on the ground. It's been one grounder after another, it seems. And I'm not sure the infield grass can take much more of this boot.
And a 1-2. Struck him out swinging. Couldn't catch up to the heater. Back to the top of the lineup. And now for the Phillies, Kyle Schwarber. A strikeout and a walk. Strike one.
Of course, you have to credit the pitching for making them beat the ball into the ground so often, but I haven't seen much of an adjustment from the hitters yet either. Got to find a way to get under the ball a little bit more and get it in the air.
The Brewers up big in this one, and we're at the top half of the sixth. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth. Trey Turner at the plate. The shortstop takes the ball. Two outs, base is empty. Swing and a base hit. And that keeps the inning alive.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Harper stands in now, looks at that one inside. That's hard hit on the line. Freeland right there to make the grab, and that'll do it. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom of the sixth inning. And now the right fielder, Sal Freeland. As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm delivers. Check swing, went around, strike one. That's down and in. Line drive. And that's a base hit, and the leadoff man aboard.
Nice line drive to the pole side right there, but he didn't spin off of it. That's the key. You still have to extend through the baseball in order to hit a line drive like that.
On the ground, a second, might be two. There's one. On the first double play. Back to the top of the Milwaukee order. Now it's the second baseman, Bryce Turang. He's already homered in this game. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. Two down, nobody on. Here in the bottom of the sixth. Foul ball there. Tap dances out of the way of that one. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. Here in Milwaukee, now it's the right fielder, Nick Castellanos. Here comes a pitch. There's the strike of the knees. Sliced hard, but foul. The pitch. Ripped on the ground a second. On to first. And the leadoff hitter set down to open the seventh. Bryson Stott digs in now. Just missed.
I can't play around with him here. It's a six-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters even if you give up a solo shot.
And a good eye there.
That's a ball.
Base is empty, one away. Here in the top half of inning number seven. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. And now it is JT Realmuto, known for his rocket arm behind the plate. That misses, and that's ball one. Slapped hard the other way, but foul. Right-hander kicks, deals. Outside low. Yeah, that's ball two. Two outs. That one ripped. That's back. And it's gone. And they're chipping away. It's 6-1. And digging in for Philadelphia, Brandon Marsh. That one in there across the letters. And a swing and a miss there.
More and more guys are looking to slug regardless of the count. In this situation, we'll keep a close eye.
Good catch up to the heater. Back here at American Family Field, set for the last half of the seventh. Up now for Milwaukee, Jackson Chourio. The wind of the pitch. Hammered on a line to the left, base hit.
The batter, the designated hitter,
William Contreras, up now for the Brewers, one for three. In there for strike one. Kicks and fires.
Ball.
Little trouble with this one behind the plate. And he'll move up to second, no problem. Should be a pass ball, and that takes away the double play. And a foul ball. Runner at second, nobody out. Fights that one away, still 1-2. And the righty deals. Headed down the line. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. Got it by him for the K.
Now got it.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Willie Adames.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
And that skips in the dirt. One out and a runner at second. Here at the bottom of the seventh. And a weak ground ball to the left side. Whips it across, and they get Adames for the out. Gary Sanchez.
RBI knock for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. Can't get there, and now maybe extra bases. The run comes in to score from second. It's 7-1. Safe at second with a double. Third hit for him this afternoon.
Picks himself up at RBI. Challenged him with the fastball right in the heart of the zone. He was clearly ready to jump all over it.
Now here is that one the other way. And that's down. A base hit. Coming home. Fires it to the plate. It's off the line and he scores. And they're pulling away up by 7 now.
Well, clearly
Tanner Banks takes over on the mound.
And with the big deficit on the scoreboard, he almost has to just put that out of his mind. Every outing matters for relievers and their numbers, but I think it's tough to get up for this type of appearance the same way you would for one in a close game.
And a pitch.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
Mitchell leads off first with two down to the inning. And 1-2.
That's the ball. 1-2.
Gets a piece and stays alive.
You can see he was trying to stay back long enough to handle the off-speed pitch, but just a little tardy on the fastball.
And now the lefty. Ground ball to the right side. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Colby Milner.
Compared to some days, this is a pretty low leverage appearance for him, so he should be fairly free and easy out there. Still have to keep yourself sharp and attack the strike zone.
And the pitch. Clemens 1-0. In the box here lets that one go for a ball. And that's in there at the knees for a strike.
One ball, this one situation, strike. You expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
Left-hand hitter waits.
That's a ball.
Just missed.
Ball. Counts full.
There's a swing and a drive. And that one hops the wall. Around first, heading for two. And he greets the new arm from the bullpen with a double.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
Rojas in the box now. No balls and a strike. Just missed. No outs.
One and one.
Runner on second. Swing and a ball hammered left field. And that one hops the wall. Run comes in from second. It's 8-2. And that's a double.
Seeing some good swings from him right now with consecutive extra base hits. When you connect and it jumps off your bat like that, you're thinking double at the very least. Put a great swing on it, and man, he wasn't fooled at all.
Smoked on the ground a second. Fires over to Hoskins. First out in the top of the eighth. Trey Turner with a chance now.
The goal is to give your teammate a chance to score from third. There's a few ways he can get it done, but his best chance is to drive one in the air. Look for the right pitch up and then smoke it.
1-0.
Next offering is in for a strike.
1-1.
One run across in the frame so far, and we're in the top of the eighth. Next offering way off the plate. Out to short, lays out, but he can't squeeze it. The runner from third comes across as they get one back, and it's 8-3. Here's Harper now. On the ground right side, 4-6-3, double play, and the inning is over. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Jose Alvarado.
Well, they need someone to stop the bleeding and keep the score right where it is. Seems like a tough task today with the way this lineup is swinging it.
The pitch. Freeland in now. Takes ball one off the plate. He caught it behind his back. Throw to first and very nicely done for the out. Now Joseph Ortiz up now for the Brewers. That clips the corner. Alvarado, the lefty who lights up the radar gun. He features a sinker, a cutter, and he works in a four-seamer. Swing and a ball lifted left field. Brings it in with a nice running grab. And there's two away. So two down now, and here is Bryce Turan. He's already homered here in this one. Pitch misses. Ball one.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
Two down, nobody on. And another ball.
Boom, he never moved because he never had time to. With that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Wouldn't chase that time. And there's a foul ball. Two outs. Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. Thank you. 3-2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Inside ball four. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat. So man aboard. Next for the Brewers, Jackson Chourio. Step off, throw to first, and he's back in safely.
One ball, no strike.
And a pitch out, but nothing going on. Swing and a pop-up. Foul and a play off to the right side. That'll find the stands. Here's a 1-1. That one fouled off. Terang, the runner at first with two gone. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. The 1-2. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And he deals. Swing and a miss, struck him out. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Joel Piantz.
And he's got a nice lead to work with, so he should come in throwing strikes, attacking these hitters.
And here comes Castellanos, leading things off, and takes a strike. Fly ball center field, and that'll fall for a base hit.
These days most outfielders play pretty deep, and I'm not sure if that was a factor there or not, but off the bat you're thinking it's going to be a pop out, and it just kind of nestled into that spot where no one was able to get to it.
Stop stands in now and watches strike one.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
Next offering is downstairs. Nobody out. Runner at first. And a pitch lifted in the air right center field. Frelich has a beat on it, and there's one down. JT Realmuto will hit next. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively but runs pretty well, so when you're looking at that position you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. The 1-0. And another ball.
And I think that skill set really upgrades the position, because when you have that kind of speed, it makes the whole team that much better.
The Brewers leading by five here at the top of the ninth. Swing and a miss. Nice changeup. What about him playing another position on defense, one that would require a little more range?
Absolutely. And I think if push came to shove where they had to make a move during a game, it'd surprise a lot of people. You might even be able to put him in center field.
So it's their last chance in this one. Brandon Marsh stands in for the Phillies. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Two outs.
Ball.
A That one fouled off. 2-2. One strike away. Just misses with that one.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
And that'll do it.
Whether you're a season ticket holder or you just come to a couple of games a year, to see your team win at home, there's just something special about that. Good job by this team to get it done for the hometown fans.
8-3 the final in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Schauble. Thanks for joining us. The final round.